flat. One of them I got to fix the wing on. Messed up. I broke it off. Fix the propane tank. Keep us warm. I'll get the chainsaw out of the case. We'll go see if we can figure out how to cut a hole. Oh boy. Drop off. Get all these set on the ice. A little soft on the edges, but thick in the center.
I had a girlfriend like that one.
Well, the wire hole is going to be a mud hole. Flappers on the edge, those X flappers there. Our open hole kind of looks like a mud pit, but if that snow comes in, the wind starts, I think we'll be all right. We just got to make them halfway blind so they can't see our mistakes.
Hold still, guys.
Come, guys.
Wreckage. Bones. Watch the other one.
Watch that one.
Maybe not. Let him come behind us. He's going to come right behind us. Now kill him.
There you go.
They flared at the last minute, but it wasn't horrible, I guess. Here. Good boy, here.
Yeah.
I think they flared probably because of the chunky ice bullcrap, but... And no wind.
And no wind. Good boy.
But we'll take him.
I name cranked that, actually.
Yeah.
Heel. Heel.
As I'm Phil mean.
Heel.
That was awesome.
Heel. Back. We'll check some heel, boys.
Kill him, guys. Bones. Go ahead and shoot that single. Shoot him.
Nice shot.
Ready, shoot your lanes. Come, guys. I got one. One shot and had to stop.
Yeah, I didn't even shoot.
They did flare out there, though.
Kill him, boys! America. Deep. It's old still. Back left, come back side. Come on, come on. You on
him? Yep.
Kill him, guys. He came on my end. I had to kill him. Sorry, guys.
Kill him, guys. Oh, no, it's fine. I'll get it.
All right, we're done. Picking up. Getting ready to take a picture here. South Dakota, second to our last day out here. It's cold. Pretty much everything's frozen. The only thing that's not frozen is a couple of pockets. The birds are kept open. But a little tip for this hunt is we came out here. We're going to break a hole in the ice. We took the chainsaw here earlier, as you saw. We were cutting a hole. But once we got it broke down, we realized it was pretty much a big mud flat. There wasn't much water in there. So it didn't really work out like we wanted to. It pretty much ended up being a mud hole instead of a water hole. But it still worked. Birds going back to water, but still worked. We killed a pile of geese, a couple ducks right here in the hole. A lot of sleeper shells, full bodies, all fully flat decoys around. We got them. We got in between the birds. A lot of birds are feeding to the north of us and some to the south of us. When you do something like this into a big pond or something or a bean field, if it's snow covered, your decoys can be seen from a long ways away, very visible. So geese would come out of the lake, they'd see us from a long ways away, and most of them are cupped up the whole time as soon as they get off the water. But it's a good tip for you. Try something different late season. Break a hole open if you can. Don't hurt yourself. Try to get in a pond where it's less or a little bit more than an inch of water, because all this is just ended up being mud. But we still shot them. Probably could have shot a few more if the snow wouldn't have started, because it keeps covering our decoys up. But we had fun. Had our buddies up from Missouri, Mr. Geo. And Geo. Why do they call you Geo?
George.
Yeah, why not just George? You don't like George?
It sounds old.
You kind of look like Elmer Fudd with that hat on.
I like it though. Warm.
I know. But anyway, we're going to pick up, take everything off the ice, and go have some nice warm dinner at the lodge. And tomorrow we got one more day to see if we can shoot a few in the face. But how many did we end up with? 27?
27.
27 honkers, two mallards, basically running traffic on a frozen pond. So it was pretty cool. Pretty fun. Now the work starts. More work. Let's, yeah, more work.